let's talk about the four stages of relationships that are headed towards a breakup. First stage is self-abandonment. This is when you push your needs aside, you abandon your desires, you don't own your voice, you people please, all for the sake of trying to attain somebody's love and affection. So you minimize yourself, you quiet yourself, you distance the truth of who you are from this very person that you say you love. And you do this not consciously, but you do this because you think that who you truly are isn't good enough. You think that if you have needs and requests and want to share who you are and what you're feeling, that it's going to push that person away. So you self-abandon and you betray who you truly are in order, in hopes, to find love. Second stage is resentment. This is when things get a little crunchy in the relationship. Why? Because if you or your partner have been people-pleasing and self-abandoning, now you're starting to get a little ticked off. Now you start to look at your partner and say, I'm doing all these things for you. I'm overworking, overgiving, overfunctioning, betraying myself in order to make you happy, and it's still not enough. Or I'm still not getting what I need. And so resentment starts to brew under the surface, but wherever there is resentment, there is self-betrayal. And that is always my sign that I have betrayed myself somewhere along the path. The third stage is indifference. It's whatever. You're neither all in or all out. You're kind of just neutrally going through life, maybe as roommates if you live together. Maybe the sex is sporadic or uneventful at best, but you're not glued in. You're not dialed in. You're not intentional. You're kind of just apathetic. And this leads to the fourth stage, which is where we repeat this cycle. Most of the time we go, okay, I'm in this stage of indifference, or my partner's in this stage of indifference. Maybe that's the wake-up call. Maybe this is the wake-up call we both needed to get back in the relationship. And so we overcorrect, and we overcorrect, but yet we repeat the same cycle of self-betrayal, resentment, indifference. And we repeat that cycle because we're unaware of where we betray in the first place. So if you know that you and your partner have been in that cycle, which I was for a long time with my husband, you have to get wildly honest about where you are playing that game of self-betrayal. And that's a hard, hard pill to swallow, because often we want to look at our partners and say, yeah, but they're not doing everything right. If they only did this, if they only changed, if they, then it would be better. And that might be true. But all we can be is responsible for our own side of the work. So start with asking yourself this question: am I being fully myself in my relationship? And if not, what would change? What would be different? What conversations would we have? What needs would I bring to the table? What desires would I express? What would have to change in the culture of our relationship in order for me to feel more authentic? This is the first step to breaking the cycle of self-abandoning, resentment, and indifference, and hopefully getting your relationship back on track towards sovereign love.